संपल्यानंतर तुम्ही सिग्नल देता ना, सुरू करू. गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज शरद दिघे. आय एम वर्किंग एज असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग ऑफ प्रवरा इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल सायन्सेस. स्टुडंट्स, वी ऑफन कम अक्रॉस विथ रिमार्क्स लाईक एक्स वाय झेड स्टुडंट फॉर अँड सो पर्सन ही इज इंटेलिजंट और ही इज डन. सो मेनी टाइम्स वी लेबल द स्टुडंट्स लाईक इंटेलिजंट और डल स्टुडंट्स, and this labeling is based on the performance of the students and the grades which he obtains in his school or college. But we you must have come across with few people like those who were really good in their academics in their college or in the schools, but they failed in their life and vice versa. So is it like that if some person scores good marks in the academics, he will succeed in his life? So today we are going to, today I am going to answer all these queries, and today is my topic for lecture is intelligence. So let us start. So firstly, coming to the objectives of this lecture, so at the end of this lecture, learners will be able to define the term intelligence, understand the nature of intelligence, discuss the types of intelligence. Fourth, know the concept of intelligent quotient, that is that means IQ. Describe the theories of intelligence, identify the factors influencing intelligence, and list the intelligence test. And final objective is to know the uses of studying intelligence for nurses. So firstly, this term intelligence, it has come from the Latin word intelligere, that means to understand. And in 1944, Wechsler defined intelligence as: intelligence is the aggregate or global capacity of the individual to think rationally, to act purposefully, and to deal effectively with the environment. So Wechsler believes that intelligence, it is the aggregate or it is the global capacity of individuals who can think rationally in various situations or in different situations. The person can act purposefully, he can behave or he can initiate action based on some purpose, and he can deal effectively with the environment. He can adjust with the environment. There is one more definition: intelligence is the global ability of the individual to adapt successfully to his own environment. Means it is the ability of a person to adapt or to adjust successfully to the changing environment. Then let's see the nature of the intelligence. So intelligence, it is an innate mental ability which grows and is influenced by the environment. So it is innate mental ability, means it is inborn ability, and this ability is influenced by the number of factors which are present in the person's surrounding environment. It shows the capacity to adapt to new or changed situations quickly and correctly. So intelligence is the capacity, means how individual can adapt or how individual can adjust to new situations or to changing situations quickly and correctly. Third, sorry. Third is, it is the ability to carry on higher mental processes like reasoning, criticism, rational behavior, and judgment. So we have higher mental processes like reasoning, criticism, and judgment or decision taking. And the person who has got the capacity or ability to carry on or to perform these higher mental processes, that comes under the intelligence. Fourth, it shows the capacity to observe the relationship and absurdities. That means intelligence is the capacity of an individual to observe the relationship between, to observe the relationship between different objects or different persons. And finally, it implies the capacity to learn and solve difficult tasks and problems. So it is the capability or capacity of an individual for learning and to solve the difficult or complex tasks and overcome the problems. So this is all about the nature of intelligence. Then next, coming to the types of intelligence. Mainly, intelligence is classified into three types: mechanical or concrete intelligence, social or emotional intelligence, abstract intelligence. Intelligence is classified into three types: mechanical or concrete intelligence, social or emotional intelligence, and abstract intelligence. So let us see one by one. First, coming to the mechanical or concrete intelligence, it is the ability to manipulate concrete objects and the ability to visualize relationships among objects. Means it is the ability of an individual to manipulate or to handle different concrete things or object, and the ability of an individual to visualize relationship among different objects. That ability is called as mechanical or concrete intelligence. Second type is social intelligence. It is the ability to understand social situations and act wisely in human relationships. So this social intelligence, it deals with the social situations. That means how individual understand different social situations and how he acts wisely in social situations and how he maintains human relationships, how he handles human relationship. So that ability is known as social intelligence. Then third type of intelligence is abstract intelligence. It is the ability to respond to words, numbers and letters. So abstract intelligence includes the ability of an individual to understand different words, different concepts, numbers, letters, ability to understand different ideas, to understand mathematical symbols. That ability is called as abstract intelligence. So there are three types of intelligence: mechanical or concrete intelligence, social intelligence and abstract intelligence. Then there is a concept known as multiple intelligence. So this concept of multiple intelligence was proposed by Howard Gardner. So Gardner believes that there are eight types of intelligences and he named them as multiple intelligence. So based on these eight types, he proposed a theory, and that theory is known as theory of multiple intelligences. So this theory differentiates human intelligence into specific modalities rather than seeing intelligence as dominated by a single general ability. So Howard Gardner, he doesn't believe in single general ability of intelligence. Rather, he believes in multiple abilities which person possesses. So according to Gardner, there are eight types of factors or eight types of different abilities which he names as multiple intelligence. Like, first is visual spatial intelligence, second verbal or linguistic intelligence, third logical mathematical, fourth bodily kinesthetic intelligence, fifth musical or rhythmic, sixth interpersonal intelligence, seventh intrapersonal, and eighth natural or naturalistic intelligence. So let us see one by one. First is naturalist intelligence. So it is the ability of an individual to understand living things and reading the nature. Means how person understand the nature, how you understand, how you can identify, for example, how you can identify different kind of trees in the nature and how you can name them. So that ability is called as naturalist intelligence. Second is musical. So it is concerned with the discerning sounds, their pitch, tone, rhythm and timbre. That means ability of an individual to understand different sounds, different voices and different tones. That ability is called as musical intelligence. Third is logical mathematical intelligence. So this intelligence is concerned with the quantifying things, making hypotheses and proving them. So mainly this logical mathematical intelligence, it is concerned with the mathematics. Fourth, existential intelligence. It deals with the tackling the questions of why we live and why we die. So this type of intelligence, it is higher type of intelligence. Means some individuals, they may have questions in their mind, means why they are born, what is the purpose of their life and how person dies. So he tries to find out the answer to these questions, and this kind of intelligence is called as existential intelligence. Next type is interpersonal intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence is nothing but understanding the feelings of other individual. It is the ability of individual to develop, to establish and maintain interpersonal relationship with others in the society. That means the person who has good interpersonal intelligence, he is able to develop and maintain good interpersonal relationships with others in the society. Next type of intelligence is bodily kinesthetic intelligence. So this bodily kinesthetic intelligence, it is concerned with our body activity. Means how person is able to coordinate his activities with his mind, or how he is able to coordinate his activities with his thought. That kind of intelligence is called as bodily kinesthetic intelligence. Next is linguistic intelligence. Linguistic intelligence, it is related with the language. That means it is the ability of an individual to use different words while speaking, to use more and more words. Means that is called as linguistic intelligence. Next type is intrapersonal intelligence. Intrapersonal intelligence deals with the understanding yourself, how, that means how individual feels. Person understands himself, person understands his own strength and weaknesses. Means he can understand his feelings, he can understand his emotions and behavior. So that kind of intelligence is called as intrapersonal intelligence. And last is spatial intelligence. So this spatial intelligence is the ability of individual to visualize the world in three dimensions. Means how we can visualize the objects in this space or in our environment. That is called as spatial intelligence. So these 8 types of intelligence are given by Howard Gardner, and he proposed a theory known as theory of multiple intelligences. Then there is a concept known as emotional intelligence. So in the same way, like how we have intelligent quotient, that is IQ, we also have emotional intelligence, that is called as EQ. So earlier this emotional intelligence was known as social intelligence. It is nothing but the ability to perceive, express, understand and regulate emotions. So emotional intelligence is nothing but it is the ability of an individual to regulate his own emotions and feelings. That is called as emotional intelligence. Means the person, it is believed that if person is able to regulate, or if he is able to control his own emotions and feelings, then he can adjust, he can adjust to the situations quickly. And there are some studies, those studies shows that if emotional intelligence is present or it is on higher side, then that person is likely to get success in his life. So emotional quotient or emotional intelligence, it is a greater predictor for future success than intelligent quotient. That means some studies they shows that if person is intelligent, means his IQ is higher, still he can fail in his life if he doesn't have good emotional intelligence. So that means emotional intelligence plays important role in the success of an individual than the intelligent quotient, that means IQ. So it is basis of the empathy for others, self-awareness and social skills, example eye contact, flexibility and cooperation. And it helps in building the therapeutic relationship with patient. So from nursing point of view, emotional intelligence is very important, because while working in the wards, student nurses or nurses, they should be able to understand their own emotions and feelings, as well as they should be able to understand the feelings or emotions of the patient, and they should have the capacity to control emotions and feelings of self as well as of patients, so that they can build therapeutic relationships with them. So coming to the concept of intelligent quotient, that means IQ. So this term IQ or intelligence quotient was coined by the psychologist William Stern, and he also proposed a formula to identify the IQ of an individual. So IQ is nothing but it is the ratio between the mental age and chronological age. So mental age divided by chronological age into 100 gives the intelligent quotient of a person. So here mental age means the mental development or developmental age of an individual, and chronological age means his real age. So this mental age and chronological age could be similar or it could be different. So by using this formula, we can measure the IQ of an individual. So for example, a 10-year-old boy, here 10-year-old boy means 10 years is a chronological age. With the mental age of 10, that means again his mental age is 10. So his IQ will be 100. So researchers have classified individuals based on their IQs. For example, the person will be labeled as genius if he has IQ of 140 or more than 140. The IQ for very superior individuals falls between the range 130 to 140. Superior individuals have IQ between the range of 120 to 130. The IQ of 110 to 120 is labeled as above average. Average IQ is 90 to 110. Dull average is 80 to 90. If individual's IQ is 70 to 80, he is said to be borderline. Then if IQ is less than 70, then that person is labeled as mentally retarded, or mentally, in better term, mentally challenged person. So again, that is categorized into four levels. Like if IQ is 50 to 70, then person is mild mentally challenged. If IQ is between 35 to 50, moderate mentally challenged. IQ is 20 to 35, then person is severely mentally challenged. And if IQ falls between 0 to 20, then person is said to be having profound mental retardation. So these categories are based on the IQ of an individual. Then next, coming to theories of intelligence, there are several theories of intelligence, but today in this lecture I am going to discuss about most common and accepted theories. So mainly I want to highlight three important theories of intelligence, such as Spearman's two-factor theory of intelligence, Thurston's theory of primary mental abilities, and third, Sternberg's triarchic theory of intelligence. So let us discuss these theories one by one. First is Spearman's two-factor theory. So this two-factor theory was proposed by Charles Spearman in the year 1927. So according to Charles Spearman, intellectual abilities are comprised of two factors, namely G factor, that means general ability or common ability, and second is S factor, that means specific abilities. So Charles Spearman, he believes that G factor or general ability or common ability is universal inborn ability. This it is the inborn ability of an individual, and greater G in an individual leads to greater success in life. So he believes that if general ability is greater in an individual, then he is likely to get more success in his life. Then second ability is S ability or S factor, and this is specific ability which is acquired from the environment. That means he believes that this S factor is not inborn, but it is developed or it is acquired from the environment, and that is why this S factor or specific abilities, it varies from one activity to activity in the same individual. So individual will have general abilities, that is common abilities, and he may have number of specific abilities, that is number of S factors, like S1, S2 and S3. So according to Spearman, intelligence is the sum total of all those activities. That means it is the sum total of general ability, means G factor, plus whatever specific abilities individual possesses. So it is the sum total of general and specific abilities. So this slide shows the differentiation between general factor and S factor, means general ability and specific abilities. So here you can see that G factor is universal inborn ability, means whatever abilities, whatever capabilities individual possesses from his birth, they are called as G factor or general factor, whereas S factors are learned and acquired from their own environment. Second, G factor is general mental ability, whereas S factor is specific ability. So for example, individual may have number of specific abilities, like we know that all individuals, they are not good in dancing, or all individuals cannot dance, but somebody has got that specific ability of dancing, so it is his or her specific ability. Another example, some individuals, they have very good mathematical abilities, means if mathematical problem is presented to them, they are able to solve them quickly in few moments. That means they have got that specific abilities. Some have got specific abilities for music. Some have got specific abilities for sports. So Spearman believes that each and every individual have general, means common abilities, as well as he have some of the specific abilities. Again, third differentiating factor is that G factor is constant in one individual, whereas S factor varies from activity to activity in same individual. G factor differs from one individual to another individual, and for S factor, individual differs in the amount of S ability. So these are the differentiating points between G factor and S factor. Then coming to the second theory of intelligence, Thurston's theory. This theory was advocated by L.L. Thurston in the year 1938. Thurston, he disagreed with the Spearman's idea of general factor and S factor, and he rejected the Spearman's two factor theory of intelligence. So this theory, Thurston's theory, considers intelligence as a combination of numerous separate factors. So he believes that instead of viewing intelligence as a single general ability, his theory focuses on 7 primary mental abilities. Means he disagreed with the Spearman's general factor, and he emphasized that each and every individual possesses different primary mental abilities, and he classified them into 7 primary mental abilities. So let us see which are those 7 factors. First is the verbal factor. That means the ability of an individual to think of words rapidly. Second is spatial factor. It is the ability of an individual to imagine an object in the space. Third, the number factor. It is the ability to do numerical calculations rapidly and accurately. That means the ability of an individual to make calculations or to solve the problems rapidly and accurately, that ability is called as number factor. Fourth is memory factor. It involves ability to memorize and recall. Means it is individual's ability for memorization and recall. Fifth is the reasoning factor. It is the ability to find principles and rules to understand and solve problems. So it is the ability of an individual to understand the problems and solve them. Sixth is the perceptual factor. It is the ability to perceive objects accurately and to see differences and similarities among objects. So this perceptual factor, it is the ability which is related to individual's perception. Means how we perceive the objects or things in our environment, how we differentiate, how we identify the differences and similarities among different objects. That factor is called as the perceptual factor. And seventh is the problem solving factor. It is the ability to solve problems independently. So these 7 factors are provided by the Thurston. Then coming to the third commonly accepted, widely accepted theory of intelligence, that is Sternberg's triarchic theory. So according to Sternberg, there are 3 types of intelligences. First, analytical thinking, second, creative thinking, and third is practical thinking. So first is analytical thinking. This analytical thinking deals with the problem solving abilities of an individual. Second, creative thinking, it focuses on developing, applying new ideas and creating solutions. So creative thinking is nothing but innovative thinking. So most of the researchers or scientists, they have creative thinking, they have new or innovative ideas in their mind. And third is practical thinking. It is also called as common sense and focuses on the ability to adapt to a changing environment and experiences. So practical thinking is nothing but the ability of an individual to adapt successfully to the changing or challenging environment. So this is the Sternberg's triarchic theory. So again in this slide you can see Sternberg's triarchic theory. Then, so this was all about the theories of intelligence. Then coming to the factors influencing intelligence. So as we all know that each and every individual have got different intelligent quotient, different IQs. There are reasons, there are number of factors which influences the development of an individual. There are number of factors which determines the intelligent quotient of an individual. So we are going to discuss about all these factors. So mainly these factors include nature. So how genetics and heredity affects our intelligence, that we are going to discuss. And third is nurture, means in what kind of environment individual is born and he is brought up. So mainly in genetics, it is believed that if parents are intelligent, then their children are likely to be intelligent. Then gender, in gender, there are differences in the IQ of girls and boys in some of the areas. So we will discuss about those separately. Then in nurture, that means in what type of environment individual was born and how he was brought up, that also influences the intelligent quotient of an individual. Means during the pregnancy period, what was the diet of the mother, how was the family environment, then when that child started schooling, then what was the environment of the school, the socioeconomic status of the family and race, these all environmental factors, they influences the intelligence of an individual. So this slide again shows the different factors which influences the intelligence of an individual. There are biological factors such as physical, chemical or nervous system of an individual, means physical build-up of an individual. Then hormones which are present in the body of an individual and nervous system. Then there are sociological factors which includes home, school, language and culture. And there are psychological factors such as intelligence, motivation, emotion, attitude, interest and sentiment. So let us discuss few important factors. So first factor which influences the intelligence of an individual, it is heredity and environment. So as we all know, the plant is fertile and good quality of seeds are sown in the fertile land, then definitely the production of crop will be good. So in the same way, heredity and stimulating environment are necessary for higher intelligence. The second factor which influences intelligence is gender, means whether the person is male or female. So boys and girls, they tend to be equivalent in most aspects of intelligence. So in most of the areas, in most of the aspects of intelligence, boys and girls, they likely to have similar intelligence, but there are some areas where girls and boys will have differences in the intelligence. So in case of girls tend to be stronger in verbal fluency, in writing and in perceptual speed as compared to boys, whereas in case of boys tend to be stronger in visual spatial processing. They are good in science and in solving mathematical problems as compared to girls. The third factor which influences intelligence is schooling. So when child attends school, the environment of the school influences the intellectual development of the child. If environment is supportive, if it is therapeutic and promotive, then child is likely to develop good intelligence. If environment is not stimulating, then child may not develop properly. So children from families of lower socioeconomic societies and those from families of high socioeconomic societies make comparable gains in school achievement during the school year. Next factor which influences intellectual development is poverty. The more your children spend in poverty, the lower their IQs tend to be. This poverty adversely affects the intellectual development of the child. Children from lower and working class homes average 10 to 15 points below their middle class age mates on IQ test. That means children from lower class society, they have less IQ, lower IQ as compared to the children from middle class society. In many countries, children from wealthier homes score better on IQ test than children from poorer homes. So these were the factors which influences the development of individual, intellectual development of an individual. The next, coming to the assessment of intelligence, is how intelligence can be assessed. Mainly there are three tests which are commonly used for the assessment of an intelligence of an individual. These are Stanford Binet Intelligence Scale, second is the Wechsler's Adult Intelligence Scale, and third is Indian Child Intelligence Test. So at this level, I am not going to go in detail about all these tests. You need to just remember the names of this test. Then coming to the last part of this session, that is why intelligence, studying of intelligence is necessary. It is important for nursing students. So knowledge about intelligence and its measurement is useful in understanding the nurse herself, her colleagues, as well as patients. So when nursing student studies about intelligence, it will be helpful for them to understand themselves, to understand their colleagues, their friends, their seniors and juniors, as well as it will help them in understanding their patients. Then if nurse understand about the intellectual ability of the patient, then in that case she will be in better position to help the patient. Also, knowledge about intelligence helps the nurse in diagnosing the mental subnormality or very superior intelligent patient. So based on the intellectual capacity of the patient, nurse can help the patient. She can provide the care and she can help the patient in early recovery. Also, it helps in maintaining empathy but avoid emotional attachment, which will be able to maintain therapeutic relationship with the patient. With a higher level of emotional intelligence, nurses are better able to adapt and understand the needs of their patient. By studying intelligence, student nurse will be able to identify and understand the needs of their patients. They can also better cope with their stress emotionally and improve their social skills. Also, knowledge about abnormalities in newborn and development of their intelligence helps the nurse in providing suitable care. And in disease related to psychiatric disorders, epilepsy, assessment of intelligence is of great importance in their management. So in case of psychiatric problems or psychiatric diseases, in case of epilepsy, assessment of intelligence is of greater importance in the management of those patients. So this is how intelligence is study of intelligence is useful for the student nurses. These are the few references for further study. So this is all about the intelligence. Thank you very much.